Welcome to a worship service for Thanksgiving from Mount Olive Lutheran Church in Mound, Minnesota. I'm Pastor Mike Mishock, welcoming you to join in on this service of Thanksgiving as we receive once again the good blessings and gifts that the Lord gives us through his holy word, and we respond to him with our thanksgiving and our praise. And my prayer and our prayer, all of us here at Mount Olive, is that you and yours have a very peaceful and safe and happy Thanksgiving. Let's begin by singing together the beautiful hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. The year that is drawing towards its close has been filled with the blessings of fruitful fields and healthful skies. To these bounties, which are so constantly enjoyed that we are prone to forget the source from which they come, others have been added, which are of so extraordinary a nature that they cannot fail to penetrate and soften even the heart, which is habitually insensible to the ever-watchful providence of Almighty God. No human counsel hath devised, nor hath any mortal hand worked out these great things. They are the gracious gifts of the Most High God, who, while dealing with us in anger for our sins, hath nevertheless remembered mercy. It has seemed to me fit and proper that they should be solemnly, reverently, and gratefully acknowledged as with one heart and one voice by the whole American people. I do therefore invite my fellow citizens in every part of the United States to set apart and observe a day of thanksgiving and praise to our beneficent Father who dwelleth in the heavens. And I recommend to them that while offering up the ascriptions justly due to him for such singular deliverances and blessings, they do also with humble penitence for our national perverseness and disobedience commend to his tender care all those who have become widows, orphans, mourners, or sufferers. And fervently implore the interposition of the Almighty Hand to heal the wounds of the nation and to restore it as soon as may be consistent with the divine purposes to the full enjoyment of peace, harmony, tranquility, and union. Let us pray. Let the incense of our repentant prayer ascend before you, O Lord, and let your loving kindness descend on us, that with purified minds we may sing your praises with the church on earth and the whole heavenly host, and may glorify you forever. Let's pray together Psalm 67. May God be gracious to us and bless us, and make his face to shine upon us, that your way may be known on earth, your saving power among all nations. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. Let the nations be glad and sing for joy. For you judge the peoples with equity and guide the nations upon earth. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you.
The Old Testament reading is from Deuteronomy chapter 8. The whole commandment that I command you today, you shall be careful to do, that you may live and multiply, and go in and possess the land that the Lord swore to give to your fathers. And you shall remember the whole way that the Lord your God has led you these 40 years in the wilderness, that he may humble you, testing you to know what was in your heart, whether you would keep his commandments or not. And he humbled you and let you hunger and fed you with manna, which you did not know, nor did your fathers know, that he might make you know that man does not live by bread alone, but man lives by every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. The clothing did not wear out on you, and your foot did not swell these 40 years. Know then in your heart that as a man disciplines his son, the Lord your God disciplines you. For you shall keep the commandments of the Lord your God by walking in his ways and by fearing him. For the Lord your God is bringing you into a good land, a land of brooks of water, of fountains and springs, flowing out in the valleys and hills, the land of wheat and barley, of vines and fig trees and pomegranates, the land of olive trees and honey, the land in which you will eat bread without scarcity, in which you will lack nothing, the land whose stones are iron, and out of whose hills you can dig copper, and you shall eat and be full, and you shall bless the Lord your God for the good land he has given you. This is the word of the Lord. The epistle is from 1 Timothy chapter 2. First of all, then, I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for all people, for kings and all who are in high positions, that we may lead a peaceful and quiet life, godly and dignified in every way. This is good, and it is pleasing in the sight of God our Savior, who desires all people to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. This is the word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 17th chapter. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was passing along between Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered a village, he was met by 10 lepers, who stood at a distance and lifted up their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were cleansed. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice, and he fell on his face at Jesus' feet, giving him thanks. Now he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus answered, "Were not 10 cleansed? Where are the 9? Was no one found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" And he said to him, "Rise and go your way. Your faith has made you well." This is the gospel of the Lord. In many and various ways, God spoke to his people of old by the prophets, but now in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son. Dear friends in Christ, grace and mercy and peace be to you from God our Father, from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Bless the Lord. Moses tells the people as they prepare to enter the promised land that they are to bless the Lord. And we see that or hear that over and over again, especially in the Old Testament. But what does it mean? What does it mean to bless the Lord? After all, we usually think in terms of the Lord blessing us, God giving us his good gifts, giving us his blessings. And what in the world do we have to give back to God? What does it mean for us to bless the Lord? Well, of course, it means to thank him. It means to praise him. It means to make him happy. After all, a blessing is something that makes you happy, right? And what is it that makes God happy? What is it that delights his heart? It's when you stop all your doing, all your fretting, all your worrying, all your fussing, and simply receive what he has to give to you. One time, people asked Jesus, as we read about in John chapter 6, "What must we do to be doing the works of God?" Well, that was a good question. The people wanted to please God. They wanted to bless the Lord, and they wanted to know how exactly they could and should do that. And Jesus gave them this answer. "This is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent." So to believe or to bless the Lord is to believe and to receive Jesus and all of his gifts. Our relationship with God could never begin with us blessing him, but with him blessing us. But when we receive and rejoice in his gifts, then we can bless the Lord. And what is it that God is giving you? Well, he's giving you all the gifts of his creation. Even more, he is giving you all the gifts of his redemption. That is, he is giving you himself. He has given his own life, his own blood for your salvation. And he continues to give himself to you. And he is giving you all the gifts of his sanctification. That is, he's giving you everything that shapes and forms you to be the precious new creation that you are in Christ. Matthew Henry, the very famous Bible commentator, was once upon a time, not once upon a time, but it happened for real, once he was robbed. And after he was robbed, he wrote this in his diary. He wrote, "Let me be thankful. First, because I was never robbed before. Second, because although they took my wallet, they did not take my life. Third, because they took my all, it was not much. Fourth, because it was I who was robbed, not I who robbed." God gives you life. God gives you your wallet and everything in it. If it's not as much as you want it to be, bless the Lord, because you won't miss it when it's gone. God gives you a new and eternal life through faith in Jesus Christ. And because of the gift of his Holy Spirit within you, you will not be the one who robs. Corrie Ten Boom, in her book, The Hiding Place, relates an incident that taught her to always be thankful. She and her sister Betsy had just been transferred to the worst German prison camp they had seen yet, Ravensbrück. On entering the barracks, they found them overcrowded and flea infested. Well, that morning, their scripture reading in 1 Thessalonians had reminded them to rejoice always, pray constantly, and give thanks in all circumstances. Betsy told Corey to stop and thank the Lord for every detail of their new living quarters. Corey at first flatly refused to give thanks for the fleas, but Betsy persisted, and Corey finally succumbed to her pleadings. During the months they spent at that camp, they were surprised to find how openly they could hold Bible study and prayer meetings without guard interference. And it wasn't until several months later they learned the reason the guards would not enter the barracks. It was because of the fleas. How many people and how many organizations do you think of their life and their mission in terms of blessed, to be a blessing? It's a wonderful way to look at things. It's a wonderful slogan, if you will, blessed to be a blessing. But where does it come from? Who said it first? Well, it was God. He said it to Abraham, as it's recorded at Genesis chapter 12. The Lord said to Abraham, "I will bless you and make your name great so that you will be a blessing." And then he went on to say, "In you all the families of the earth shall be blessed." St. Paul wrote to the Corinthians, as recorded in 2 Corinthians chapter 9, "You will be enriched in every way, to be generous in every way, which through us will produce thanksgiving to God." Growing up in southern Arizona, I loved to explore in the desert, and I loved to hear all of the wonderful passages in the Bible, especially in the book of Isaiah, that use desert imagery to communicate the truth of God. In the desert, there are these rock pools called tinajas, and they are a very, very important source of water and life for all the creatures that live there in the desert. And in the summertime, of course, these pools shrink, and sometimes they dry up completely. But when the rains come, they begin to be filled again. Those dry pools must be filled so that they can overflow. They receive the blessing of water so that the blessing can then pour on into others. And when you experience the gift of God, you respond with praise and worship and thanksgiving. And that's what it means to bless the Lord. Thank you. I invite you to join in singing the response to the different petitions of the prayer, Lord have mercy, and those begin as I sing the last word, Lord, then the congregation joins in and sings the response. Let's try it. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. For Matthew and for Lucas, for all pastors in Christ, for all servants of the church, and for all the people, let us pray to the Lord. For Joseph, for all public servants, for the government and those who protect us, that they may be upheld and strengthened in every good deed, let us pray to the Lord. For those who work to bring peace, justice, health, and protection in this and every place, let us pray to the Lord. For those who bring offerings, those who do good works in this congregation, those who toil, those who sing, and all the people here present who await from the Lord great and abundant mercy, let us pray to the Lord. For favorable weather, for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, let us pray to the Lord. For the faithful who have gone before us and are with Christ, let us give thanks to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. I invite you to say a silent prayer at this time, or if you're together with others, maybe you want to speak aloud some of the things for which you are thankful, the things for which you want to bless the Lord. Rejoicing in the fellowship of all the saints, let us commend ourselves, one another, and our whole life to Christ our Lord. Almighty God, your mercies are new every morning, and you graciously provide for all our needs of body and soul. Grant us your Holy Spirit that we may acknowledge your goodness, give thanks for your benefits, and serve you in willing obedience all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. The Almighty and merciful Lord, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, bless and preserve you.